pouch. Now you can pour them all in there if you want. You can assemble them part way. It's kind of a tight fit if I put the tube on, so basically whatever works for you. Now they also have what's called indicator tape. So if you don't want to put them in these bags, you can buy that, or what you can do is simply get some Scott utility towels, shop towels, wrap your parts up in there so it's all closed off. They have what looks like masking tape. It's called indicator tape. As long as you tape it off, wrap it around so that you have something that indicates it's been cleaned, you'll want to do that. And then you fire up your autoclave, otherwise known as a pressure cooker, right? What you're going to do is you're going to add. The way the pressure cooker works is the same as an autoclave, pressure and heat. What you got to do is get it over 212 degrees, 15 pounds pressure for 15 minutes. Now, pressure cookers have dials. Okay, some of them on the bigger ones will have where you have 5, 10, 15 pounds. At 15 pounds for 15 minutes above boiling. Okay, so let me show you this. So I have a separator in there, something that raises all your stuff up about 2 to 3 inches. Okay, now water boils off at a rate of a half cup every 15 minutes through the steamer. So what I want to do is add a little more to that to make sure I don't go dry. I already put enough in there for the first 15 minutes. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a cup and a half for every 15 minutes. And that gives me the half a cup per 15 minutes plus a little more to make sure it doesn't run dry. Okay, now you lock that off, turn that on, set a timer. Okay, so you turn this thing up on high until it starts to steam, and from that point on you're going to wait 15 minutes for every 15 pounds of pressure. This is a 10 pound pressure, so I'm going to wait 30 minutes from about 5 after is when it's going to start spewing. Now once it starts kicking out, you don't need it to be super high, so I'll turn it down low enough to keep the steam coming out, and at 30 minutes you shut it off. Turn it on like that, turn it down. Turn it down low, and then that way this will still keep above pressure. As long as steam's coming out, you're over pressure, but you don't need to overcook it and waste all your water. Okay? So as long as you got steam out like that, you're good. Okay, so a half hour later, you turn that off. Now you have to release the pressure. You will not be able to get this lid off until all that pressure goes down enough. There's a lock on the handle, so when that pops down, now you have relieved enough pressure to get the lid off. So at this point, I'll take this off. Now you're going to let this cool off for about a half an hour. Two reasons. One, you don't want to get burned. And the other, one side of these is paper. Wet paper tears. You don't want to tear a hole in it because you just sterilized it. So I'm going to let this cool off before I pull it out and show you the rest. Okay, so as you can see, the indicators have turned from light blue to black. So that indicates that we got enough heat and pressure. Now I'm going to do my grips, because even if you say, oh, I don't use steel, I use disposable, great, do whatever you want. some people use disposable and they use a reusable grip, which is a little bit pointless because these are touched with dirty hands all the time. So you're going to need to clean these anyway. So if you don't want to sterilize them with the autoclave, you need some of this. This will kill every fucking thing. Okay, you mix 2 ounces to a gallon for sterilizing or sanitizing, 4 ounces to a gallon for sterilizing. So you can actually rinse these off, wash them down, and then drop them into a jar with the proper amount of this in it and store it that way, and they'll stay clean. Just rinse them off really, really well when you're done. Also, you can take, like I said, for sterilizing, sanitizing, a couple ounces to a gallon of water. Then you pour that solution into some of these, and you can wipe down everything. So if it's not anything that's not covered, it should be autoclaved. If it's not autoclaved, it should be wiped down with sterilizer. One way or the other, you have to kill everything. This allows you to sanitize it, sterilize it, and then store it, because now you can't touch it until it's open. If you don't have these, like I said, wrap them up and then use the indicator tape. Another thing, if you don't have these, sealing them off, I'm going to use distilled water because, well, tap water has a lot of minerals in it, and those minerals will bake onto your stainless steel and that will look nasty. So use distilled water and wrap yourself up. You have to learn to pace yourself. Pressure. You're just like everybody else. Pressure.